Dear friends, as we said, Guru Brahma, Guru Vishnu, Guru Devo Maheshwara. The second God for us is Vishnu, who protects us. He protects us. Whatever been created by Brahma, Vishnu protects. And Vishnu is the one who not only protects us, but he takes care of us from the birth to the death. He takes care of every aspect of our life. This whole world, in the beginning, he was doing penance under the water. And Mahamaya tells him, the Adiparashakti, Mother Nature, tells him to get up and start the creation. And she shows him all the positive and negative emotions and the senses, everything are born. So he creates Brahmanda and Brahma and Rudra, and all the three takes care of this creation. Vishnu has taken many avatars. Especially the most important are 28 avatars he has taken. Now out of this dashavataras, 10 avatars are there which are very important. Each of these avatars, they say Narada is his avatar. In the dashavataras, each avatar, he comes, he finishes his work, protects this earth and the people and goes back. Main avatars again are the ones which stay, especially Krishna and Rama stayed here, Parasurama stayed here, and they have helped the mankind staying here. And they are nearby. Krishna is very near avatara, Buddha avatara. They say he will be coming as Kalki. The next avatara, he will be coming as Kalki. So all his avataras are for the good of the people. His family life, he stays in Vaikuntha. His wife is Lakshmi, is called, and she has come out from the milk sea and he has it. And he also had once cursed by Lakshmi. How? He sees her and he laughs her. He laughs at her. And she feels that, why is he laughing at me? And she says, your head should go. Then she realizes she has done a wrong thing. And she asked him to be having the horse head, high griva. So then it is also good because he has to kill one of the asuras and he kills it. So he also have a high griva head, that is horse head. But he was also cursed by Bhrigu Sage, Bhrigu, when he has killed the mother of Sukracharya. Bhrigu gets angry and he curses that he should be born as a human being on the earth. Thus Krishna and Rama and Parashurama avataras took place. He has been. He created even earth. They say it was Lord Vishnu near him. He created, when he created Brahma, from his ear wax, two asuras were killed. And both the asuras used to play. Suddenly they started becoming big and they started harassing Brahma. So Vishnu thought it is no good that he should kill them. And he wanted to kill them. They became, as he wanted to kill, they have become big, 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 very big. So he also became very big. He had his lap very big and he killed them. The fat which was there from these two hours, asuras, it was so big that he could not throw anywhere. Then from that he has made, that is, the fat was called metha, and he has filled the methani, that is the earth. He has made it out of that fat, flesh of these two asuras, the whole earth has been made. And in that way Vishnu has made the earth. He also killed Andhaka. He has many ornaments and weapons with him. If you see Lord Vishnu, he has of course a flower in hand, but he also has Sudarshan Chakra. He has a conch. He has a kada in his hand. Now these weapons always go along with him in every incarnation. He also took an incarnation of Venkateshwara. They say it is not an incarnation. Lord Vishnu has come down to earth as such. He's not been born. He has come as such. So he is a God who is being today in Kali Yuga. You see Vishnu in the form of Lord Venkateshwara. Lord Venkateshwara, once when Vishnu was in there, he went round to see that who is better to be given the fruit of the penance of the sages. He goes to Brahma Loka, he curses Brahma and comes back, and then sage Bhrigu comes to Vishnu Loka. He goes to Shiva also and he curses there that he cannot be prayed as Shiva in the form, only in the linga form he can be prayed, worshipped. Then he goes to Vishnu Loka and he gets angry and he hits on the chest of Lord Vishnu. And Lord Vishnu serves him and pierces the eye which is there in the foot. And then he understands his mistake, he goes. But Lakshmi was very angry with it. Why Lord Vishnu has done this, and she goes down. In search of her, he comes down. And when he comes down, he doesn't find Lakshmi. He just takes rest in under a snake hull where cowherd, because he is very thirsty. Lakshmi will take Lord Shiva and Brahma as a cow and calf and gives it to the king of that place. So cowherd takes the cow. He sees that the cow is going to some place and giving milk every time. So that day he sees the milk is being poured into the snake hill. He goes and hits, but suddenly Lord Vishnu gets up, he gets hurt. And he curses the cowherd, he becomes a ghost. Then he comes out and he goes in search and he hears Vakula Devi singing. Vakula Devi was in the previous birth Yashoda, and she was singing. So she goes, he goes and sits there, and when Vakula Devi comes, he shows his vision as Krishna, and she is very happy that Krishna has come to her, and he stays with her and tells her that in Krishna Avatara he did not give her a chance to perform his marriage. So she tells him, you stay here, I will see you. He says he will stay with her. He sees Padmavati there, the Akash Raja's daughter. Then he tells Vakula Devi that you have to get me married. She says okay, and she goes. And to get married, they have to take money, because in this life he was not having any money and Lakshmi was not with him. So when Lakshmi is not with Vishnu, Vishnu has no wealth. So they take as a loan from Kubera, and that loan we are still repaying in Tirupati. We are still repaying. And after the marriage, when Lakshmi comes in search, he becomes a stone there. And so, and that murti, that Venkateshwara murti, is the, actually Lord Vishnu, who is staying in Kali Yuga for us to pray him. And in that way he is here. He got many characteristics. He goes everywhere and he got many names. That's why Vishnu Sahasranamam was chanted by Bhishma when he was in the Kurukshetra war. And all the names are attributed to Lord Vishnu, and he has many forms too, and all his forms are prayed. So dear friends, let us pray Lord Vishnu to give, protect us and give us the strength that we protect the creatures, things which are with us and our children and around us, whatever is there, we protect. We have to protect the nature, we have to protect the animals, we have to protect our own children, and we have to protect our elders, we have to protect friends, we have to do everything. And that protection aspect will be given to us only by Lord Vishnu. So let us all pray for it. Thank you. Namaste. Dear friends, anyone in the world, you ask what they want, they'll say, we want wealth, money. Everybody gives importance to wealth and money first. For us, Lakshmi is a symbol of wealth. This Lakshmi was originated from the milk sea when it was churned. When she came, Vishnu has taken her as his consort. Goddess Lakshmi is the symbol of wealth, of all kinds of wealth. It's not one kind of wealth, but all kinds of wealth. There are different forms of Lakshmi, different incarnations of Lakshmi. Like Sita, Rukmini are incarnations of Lakshmi. But there are different forms of Lakshmi also. And there is, they say, even in cow dung there is Lakshmi. She asked, once she met cows, she asked cows, what do you want? Cow said, we don't want anything, because people do consider us, in India, we consider cow as a very auspicious one. And we pray cow. They said, they pray us, we are considered auspicious, we don't want. She said, still, you ask. Then they ask, well, your cow dung is not considered anything. So, you stay there. So, from then onwards, people do believe the cow dung has Lakshmi. That's why they smear in villages, they smear their houses with cow dung. So, even Lakshmi is found there also. We have Astalakshmis. Now, Astalakshmis, the first one is Adi Lakshmi. The Adi Lakshmi is the Parabrahma, that is the first wife of Lord Vishnu. With Adi Lakshmi will be there with Vishnu. Then you have Dhanalakshmi. Dhanalakshmi is the one who gives us wealth, the money, coin. Then Dhaira Lakshmi, she gives us courage and strength. Dhaira Lakshmi gives us courage and strength. Then we have Gajalakshmi. She gives us power and strength. Then we have Santana Lakshmi, who gives children, who takes care of children, who blesses us for children. Then Vijay Lakshmi, who helps us in victory, of every aspect of victory. Then we have Vidya Lakshmi. Of course Saraswati is there, but Vidya Lakshmi, who helps us in learning, who helps give us. Saraswati helps us in learning, but Vidya Lakshmi gives us that learning. Then we have Dhanya Lakshmi, which stays in the food grains. Every kind of agriculture, food grains, that is called Dhanya Lakshmi, she stays there. Then we have various Lakshmi, especially Varalakshmi. We perform Varalakshmi Vratam. Every year, Sumangalis in India perform Varalakshmi Vratam. On this day, they say that she gave her vision to an ordinary lady called Charumati, and Charumati told everybody that we should do the puja. So all the ladies get up and they do puja. After the puja, they make 9 items and give it to Lakshmi, and she is so happy, and whoever does this vratam, they get wealth. It's a small thing you do, a small gold then you buy, you keep it and do puja on that day with silver, with grains, with new clothes, everything. She gives us all the things. And this is my personal experience. After I got married, I started with a small type puja. And I know every year I was getting her blessing. And on that day we call people and give the kumkum and haldi, we call it as turmeric and kumkum. We put it and we give the bindi and we give fruits and all that. So that vratam is very important, Lakshmi vratam. There are various forms again, Moksha Lakshmi, Mahalakshmi, Sri Lakshmi, Swarga Lakshmi, all these forms. Lakshmi is there everywhere. Especially, that's why we say she comes in the morning, she sees the houses. In olden days, they used to put rangoli before. So they say, open the door and keep it. So she gets into the house in the morning. Again in the evening, she comes and sees who all are putting the lights or not. Are they living in darkness? If you live in darkness, she will not come in. So your house should be bright. You should have the Lakshmi Peetham, that is the God, the place where gods are there. So gods will come. Lakshmi always tests us. And she will come and she will stay with you if you keep her properly. That's why, dear friends, the plastic money is harassing us. Plastic money makes, that's why the money doesn't stay with us. Do the puja, proper puja to this Lakshmi. Keep the coins, gold coins or silver coins or ordinary coins with Lakshmi. Do puja, ask her, she will give. So whatever you have, you should spend. Within your limits, you should spend. Then she will give again. You give whatever you have to people. You give 1 rupee, she will give you 10 rupees. But first thing, you should give. So it is not that we take her and lock her in our cupboards. We should go on spending in a proper way. Giving alms, giving donations, giving to poor people. At the same time, spending within our limits. Not going out of limits, then she will not. And if you do good puja to her, she will always be with you. So let us pray to that Lakshmi who can give us and ask her to give all the Lakshmis, Ashta Lakshmis and Varalakshmi to bless us. Thank you.